I'm Jason Kessler, and I am one of the cyber resilience specialists here at NetApp. You may be at this point in the stage of this series, why is NetApp so interested in security? There's a lot of reasons, but one of the big ones is that there's a lot of stuff going on, and we want to do our part to making sure that the attacks stop. Data is one of the most valuable possessions that an organization has, and the storage platform is really the last line of defense. But let me tell you a story about how one of these attacks may play out. So assume we have a user. This user is any user, nothing special, right? They do their job, they have access to the access that they have, and really what they have is access to a specific set of data. What we want to do is, they know what data they have. This is what they do, right? They have access to that. But what we find is that when an attacker, we'll just create the little evil guy. What happens is this attacker, through a phishing attempt in most cases, breach our perimeter, breach our security, and compromise this user. And now this user becomes evil in some manner, becomes corrupted. Now this attacker that's actually doing the attack, now that they have access into our environment, though that access is limited, has a very limited access to this, what they really want is to get their privileges elevated. If they could come in and actually compromise one of our admins, this would be awesome for that attacker. So what are they going to do? They need to discover who that admin is. So through access to our already corrupted user, through the searching of our email database, searching through our Active Directory capabilities, the attacker discovers this admin. Now, many of us, we're pretty security savvy at this point. We go through our annual security training. We take it pretty seriously. We don't click on just any link that comes our way, especially when it might even be coming from a user that we don't interact with very often. So what happens? So let's take this a little further. Let's actually look at how persistent some of these attackers actually take. So this attacker knows that this admin exists. And in the midst of all of their research in this, they actually find out that this admin, they have a Facebook account. And through this Facebook account, they discover that she has, an 8-year-old. That 8-year-old goes to school, right? In that school, they have teachers. Now this teacher, as good as they are, didn't have the security awareness that our admin had. And that teacher maybe clicked on an email that had a bad link. Maybe the password that she uses was just not quite up to snuff. But what happens is the attacker now has corrupted the teacher's accounts. And what do they do? They may send an email saying, hey, we have a new policy at school. That policy is that you need to fill out this form and have your child bring it in tomorrow, or they're not allowed at school anymore. It needs to get done. This is really important. It's a new policy that we're putting in place. We got urgency. So we open this email and download that document. Well, that document is corrupted or is malicious. And it takes over another computer in the account in the household, propagates through the network inside the household, and now the admin's computer has been corrupt. It has been compromised through no fault of the administrator, and possibly through a zero day that we haven't patched or didn't know about. The administrative account, the administrator's account and computer is now corrupted, and then which it allows us to now come in from behind and have access into your organization. Why is NetApp so concerned and so focused on providing the strongest and most secure storage platform on the planet? Is to prevent the unknown. This was never known. This was not, in most cases, wasn't even thought of. That is, that a circumvent could occur. So we want to put in protections, controls, and controls for controls to prevent events like this. Check our next episode, or check in the episode on how we handle authentication with ONTAP, to cover how we can help you secure yourself from these types of events. See you on the next one.